Hello, you lovely people. Welcome back to my channel. You know, I was sitting down here earlier and I was thinking, what I fancy doing today? And I thought, I know what, we'll do a microcomputer. You all know what a microcomputer is, don't you? And you certainly know which microcomputer I'm going to be talking about because you saw the intro. But yeah, I feel like doing a microcomputer. They're an interesting, tiny little things, aren't they? Yeah, they are literally micro. Android based usually, yeah. And which one are we talking about? Well, as I said, you know, because you've seen the intro. We're talking about the Ouya, guys. Yeah, one of the most unsuccessful consoles probably of all time. One of, there's been a few, isn't there? But yeah, we're talking about this little bugger here. Yeah, look at that. How minimalistic does that look? It is fantastic. I love this little thing. I love it to bits. I know a lot of people hate it. There's the only ports on the back there, guys. There's the top with the power button. Big old power button on top there. And there's the bottom, guys. And that is basically what it looks like. Like an ornament when it's out on display. Looks bloody lovely when it's out on display. Yeah. But funny enough, this was the ninth highest grossing Kickstarter at the time. It actually generated 8.9 million or something. Absolutely phenomenal. The industry loved it. It won awards. Everybody was just waiting on bated breath to see how this thing would go. Unfortunately, it didn't go well. It wasn't helped by the fact that the CEO of the company, Julia, I do believe it's Ullman, she went on in an interview and they basically buried herself. If you want to see that, look on YouTube because there's loads and loads of them on there showing the interview. And she basically buried her own company with having absolutely no idea what she was even talking about her own product. Yeah, so it didn't have a good start there, really. The lovely thing about the Ouya is you can literally dismantle that if you wanted to take screws out and tinker with it. You can sideload things onto it like emulators and things. So it has a really, really good place. Still, I think. And the question we're going to be asking is, should you buy an Ouya in 2020? Well, we're going to address that shortly. First of all, we're going to talk about, you know, its lifespan and so on, which wasn't good, guys. It was released in 2012, as I say, through a very, very, very successful Kickstarter. It only lasted 3 years, guys, till 2015. And then people were getting fed up with the lackluster games that were coming to their store. In the end, the software was bought in 2015 by Razer. And they carried on kind of supporting it a bit, but they discontinued the unit. So I haven't hooked it up for quite some time, guys, so it'll be a bit interesting for me to see what's actually going to happen when I do hook it up. Is there still anything there? Yeah, is there? We'll find out, won't we? As I take the little bugger upstairs and we have a look. So yeah, guys, it's such a shame. It really is such a bloody shame. Obviously, my Ouya collection is very small because you only had digital. There is no physical games for the Ouya, of course. Another one that's absolutely slated, the controller. I love this thing. I know it has its snags, you know, sometimes the buttons get a bit stuck and so on. It's got a weird way of putting batteries in, you've got to rip the front off to put the batteries in and so on. But I love it. And I'll tell you what, somebody else bloody loved it as well, because this has made a comeback as a Switch controller, a third-party, cheapish Switch controller. It's now in, obviously, red and blue, but it's definitely the same shell, guys. So, yeah, it's been used as a Switch controller. Can't have been that bad, can it? Although the reviews of that Switch controller are not damn good, I can tell you that now. But yeah, I like this. I liked it so much, I was the one person on the face of the planet probably to go and buy two of them. Yay! So yeah, guys, let's take it upstairs, have a look, see what the store's up to, if it's still running, and if we can actually do anything with the bloody thing still, shall we? Okay then, see you in a minute. Right, guys, here we go. Just loading up the Ouya now. Disclaimer, guys, there might be a lot of noise outside. I'm filming this during the day, so yeah, lots of work going on out there and just basically random noisy people. Right, let's see what we can do here. Did you hear that? That is so funny. It still makes me chuckle that when it comes to that sequence. Ouya! Right, guys, here we go. Here's the menu. You've got play, discover, make and manage. Also, in the bottom there, you've got select and system menu where you do your settings and so on. I've discovered one thing because I plugged it in earlier just to get my head around it again. I haven't played it on for so long, you know. If you have your Wi-Fi set to it these days, you'll get nowhere. You won't be able to play any of the content that's on it because it's going to try and see if you're allowed to play it, kind of thing. It's going to do that. So if you disconnect the Wi-Fi, you can get to what's on it and still play it. So it's doing a kind of like a checker to see whether you've got the legal software, I suppose. But it seems that the store doesn't exist anymore, so it doesn't really matter about connecting the Wi-Fi, guys. So that's number one. That's a downer. But of course, you can sideload things onto it. What do I mean by that? Well, you can get yourself a memory stick and you can download all the games for your PC. And then you can sideload them through the memory stick onto the unit itself because it has 16 gig built into the machine. So it's not an absolute downer. There is still ways of certainly playing your emulators and so on here. And there's still ways of getting hold of the content that used to be there, namely the games and so on. You can just download them these days through like almost like an APK. So yeah, let's go into the games now. He says if it's going to let me. Come on, you little swine. Why are you doing that? Come on. Just got to turn the controller back on, guys. Sorry. Here we go. That's it. I think we're there. Yeah, there we are, guys. Right, for instance, look here, here's the menu now with all the software that's on here already. As you can see, you've got like an almost like a futuristic racing game, very much like Wipeout. You've got a Nintendo DS emulator, a kind of Minecraft-y game, I presume. Delta Strike, Game Boy Color emulator, Real Speed, Castlevania ripoff. PC Engine, NES, and so on and so on. Lots and lots of stuff on here, guys. Lots of it. There we are. Lots of it. Donkey Kong at the end there. Right, so let's go over here first. Shall we have a look at a futuristic Wipeout clone? Yeah, let's do that now. See, when I tried to connect to this earlier with Wi-Fi, it would not have it. It just kept telling me it couldn't be verified. So, yeah, that seems to be a bit of a downer, guys, that you're not going to be able to get onto the internet by the looks of it, unless I find a workaround. Here we go, guys. This is a lovely little game, this one. I'm just gonna have a quick chug on my coke. Right, as you can see, career mode, single player time trial. That music is even very Wipeout, wasn't it? Yeah, a definite Wipeout clone, this one. Right, okay, we're going to single race. I just a quick play here. Yeah, that'll do. Very easy. It does look bloody lovely still. It really does. I mean, look at that. Yeah, it's not, you know, state of the art as everything is these days, but come on, it's, you know, it's bloody good enough, isn't it, eh? Here we go, so you can see how much of a wipeout clone this one is. Jeez Louise. It's a brilliant little game. It really is. As I say, you can still get these games, you just have to download them off the net. You know, Google's your best friend and all that. And sideload them on. Through the memory stick. You can't put micro SD cards or SD cards in general on the Ouya, but you can use memory sticks, so that's lovely. And shoot the other buggers. Here we go. Oh, is that a weapons of ours? No. Yeah, you can see that one's lovely. This is a little gem on the Ouya, it really is. I tell you what, it's a little bit easier than bloody Wipeout. No, Wipeout, as much as I love it, it's a very difficult one, isn't it? Ooh, there we are, yeah. Again, I love the controller on the Ouya, it's lovely, I think. Oh, everybody else hates it so much. It's got so much hate, the Ouya. The only person I've seen recently who loves the Ouya as much as me is John Hancock. Fantastic little thing. There we are. As you can see, very much like Wipeout, guys. Right, there we are, yeah. Fantastic little thing, that really is. Right, I'll be back in a sec, I'll get back onto the menu. Right guys, shall we have a look at an emulator this time? Yeah, sounds like a good idea, doesn't it? Which one shall we pick? Let's have a look. Let's have a look. Sport for choice, guys. Oh, here we go. Shall we have a look at Game Boy Advance? Yeah, that's a good idea, I think. Right, load game. Oh, got a few there to try anyway, guys, haven't we? Yeah, shall we try Wario Land 4? Restart. Is my Nintendo going to smack my ass for me? It's brilliant having these emulators on here because it breathes new life into the old Ouya and it gives you a purpose to keep it, doesn't it, except for having it as an ornament. Right, shall we skip that, guys? I think so, eh? Here we go. Let's see how this thing plays, shall we? I can tell you now, they play stunningly on here, they really, really do. Come on, Mario. No, sorry, Wario. How dare I call him Mario? He'd hate me forever, wouldn't he? Oh dear. No happy music anymore. Alright, come on. Get yourself down there, you fat evil person. Right, here we go then, guys. I'm entering the passageway. Okay then, off we go. Yep, thank you very much. Hey! Right, here we go, guys. Oh yes, that one. Oh, I thought that's where he went. Yes, it is. Oh, it's playing absolutely fantastic, guys. It really is. Brilliant. Oh, we've got to run and do it at the same time. Oh, yes, a bit hard to do. Oh, come on, you. Oh, we're going to be here forever, guys. But yeah, you can see it's playing beautifully, guys, can't you? Absolutely brilliant. Yeah, right, back in a minute, guys. Right, back we are, guys. Let's have a look at another game before we go on to the emulators, shall we? Let's have a look at the Castlevania clone, shall we? See if that one's going to work, all right, or not. Oh, press the wrong one, guys. Let's go back. There we go. There we go, guys. Let's see if this one's going to play. I'll leave it to play for a bit if it does. Right, let's see what it plays like, shall we? Come on, you. That's it. Right. Come on in. Let's get on with it. Actually, I would say it's not like Castlevania at all, it's more like Ghouls and Ghosts, isn't it? Oh yes, absolutely, there's Arthur. Goblins and Ghosts and Ghouls and Ghosts, whatever. Yeah, that's what it's like, guys. He's going to lose his suit of armour as well, I bet. Come on, you guy. It's a bit easier than that, though, because oh, that is one hell of a franchise and they're very, very difficult to play, so this is a hell of a lot easier, guys, that's for sure. Same thing though with the little lances and things. It's just hilarious that they got away with this, really, isn't it, to think this was released as well commercially, kind of thing. It's such a blatant copyright, it's unreal, but it's brilliant. And I have to say it is bloody good. Come on, you swine. Yeah, that's it, got you and all. Oh, this is terrific, guys, it really is. Are you alive? Oh, you are alive. Oh, you swine. Oh, so, right, okay, so I've got... Ah, bugger. Shall I get you like that? Yes, I do. Oh, yeah. Oh, you swine. Right, here we go again. Give it another go. Yeah, all right, then come on, shoot your little... Well, it looks like lances, but it's actually a sword, isn't it? Some kind of thing. Don't you kill me already. Yeah, you die. Oh, there's him again. One out of the way, that's it. Yep, that's it, good. Well, it's a fun little game, this has to be said. It really is. Wow, everything can be killed by the looks of it. Cool. Yep, that's it. Whee. How do I get that then? Oh, you have to shoot it, of course, here. Yeah. Oh, this is terrific, guys. Absolutely terrific. Fabulous game, apart from that swine there. Okay. You definitely have to get a little bit higher to kill him. Oh dear me. Oh no! No! Oh dear me. My bad playing again, guys. But whoa, that's a little doozy, isn't it? Hey, that's a fantastic little game, that. Wow. Whoa, apart from I'm pressing the wrong blinking button again. I'm trying to play it like he would, Ghouls and Ghosts. That is the trouble here. Go on, you die. Let me try again, guys. Yeah, one more go, guys, and then we'll have a look at something else. I'm enjoying this too much to just let it go now. This is fantastic. Really, really is fantastic. Oh, yeah, you got you, swine. That's it, get you. I've got to go down here, want me to get that thing. There we go. Oh, I've got him already, good. Cool. Yeah, and then, yeah. Oh, come on then, you. That's it, get that. Whee, okay, same again. Oh, yeah. Oh. No. I'm determined for him not to get me this time, guys, come on. Oh, dear me, eh? Oh, he got me anyway. It's the controls are reverse, guys. That doesn't help matters, I tell you. No, no, no. Right, there we go, guys. Well, that was a good look at that one. Right, I'll go back to the menu and have a look at another one. Right, back in again, guys. Right, let's have a look at another one. Let's have a look at this one here. At real speed. Let's have a look at this one. I leave that to play again, guys. Oh, very simple menu there. Race, settings and so on, yeah. Okay then, we shall race. Let's see what the graphics look like on this. Oh, we're straight into it. Wow, I wasn't expecting that, guys. Oh, wrong one. Here we go. Right, okay. Bit of a tester, this, huh? Oh, yeah, that handles all right. Graphics look okay. At the moment. Just me playing badly again. Yeah. Well, it certainly doesn't look too bad. I'll get back up there, you. No music in the background. That's a bit strange. I don't know why I just expect music to be there. I mean, it is a racing game. Not all racing games have music in the background as you're racing, of course. Oh, right, I'm first. You. So I was first because nobody playing against me, guys, that's why. Right, okay. Right, let's see. Is that it then? Is that all you can do? That's a bit... crap. Oh, no, here we go, guys. Here's more of a menu. Right, let's have a bit of a vape. So, yeah, you can customise your car a bit more here with speed, acceleration and handling. I think we'll just keep it all the way it is. Oh, no, I quite like that, actually. Ooh, let's see the one. Ooh, yeah, we'll go back to that one. Ooh, I like that. Yeah. Right, okay, so let's press A, shall we? Handling, blah, blah, blah. Let's see. Yeah, select. Here we go. Right, okay. Oh, right, you get to actually choose a track now. That's good. So we'll move on a bit. We'll go to a different track. Let's see if we've got anybody to compete against this time, shall we? Oh yeah, there we are. They're all well overtaking me there.
So yeah, you do get a proper race here. I was starting to wonder if it was an online game only, and of course it wouldn't work now. My terrible playing again, guys. As I say, I've played all these games before, but not for a very, very long time. And yeah, that is hindering me, shall we say, more than usual. I know I play crap anyway, but Jesus. Right, here we go. Oh, come on, you. I thought I could use the D-pad, but you can't. You have to use the sticks. Oh, look at that. Oh, how terrible am I? Like, no wonder I'm bloody fourth place. Oh, no, third or fourth. Right, okay. There's someone worse than me. There can't possibly be. Oh. Yeah, I'm not really liking the handling of this. It's very, very, very dodgy. Oh, look, he's overtaking me now as well. Now I am fourth. Oh, no, we're back again. Back to third. Yeah, the handling of this isn't too hot. I mean, it looks all right, doesn't it? And you might get on with it very, very much better than I am. It certainly looks all right. Sounds okay with the sound effects there. Yeah, doesn't seem to be too bad. He just seems to be purposely trying to be last, really, isn't he? He gets so, oh, I'm doing the same thing, guys. Oh, dear. Right, well, I think we're going to quit that one because I'm not getting on very well with it, am I? Back in a sec. Right, look at another emulator, guys. Let's have a look at, where's it gone? Where have you gone, you? At the PC Engine I wanted to have a look at. Where is it? Right at the front. There we go, guys. Okay, let's have a look at the PC Engine. There's only one game on here, if I remember right, Magical Chase, which is one of the best ones anyway. Let's have a quick look at it. Hit play again. Of course, it's one of the most expensive games on the PC Engine, if you're trying to get a physical copy of it. You certainly would have to have very, very deep pockets, guys. Right, how do we get this started then? Come on, you. Oh, there we go. Right. Breezy. Yes, that'll suit me very nicely. Thank you. Bit of breeziness, yeah. Come on. How do we start you? Oh, there we go. Right. Right, here we go. Of course, this is a cute and up, where you're shooting everything in sight, but it's cute at the same time. Whoa, they're all getting me, of course, as well. Oh, this is absolutely fantastic again. Brilliant emulation again. Oh, the bloody heads, they're horrible there. Oh, there you go. Loads of buggers. Oh dear. These surfing hamsters. That's what they look like. Dear me. Oh, it's just like everything. Everything's coming at you at once on this game. It's not only an expensive game, it's a very hard one as well. But absolutely stunning looking, of course. Oh, I died. Oh dear. Seriously, man. Come on. Get on with it. Yeah, alright, you're taking the mickey now. Yeah. Oh dear, eh? Right, back in a minute, guys. That was a very quick one. Right, let's have a look at NES games next, shall we? Alright, here we go. Only two games on here. Little Samson and Mario Brothers. So, shall we have a look at one of the most expensive games on the NES? God, does this cost a lot of money. You're looking at least like £1,000 for this game. It's absolutely phenomenally expensive. Here we go, guys. Restart. Right, here we go. He says, how do we start this one then, eh? Oh, there we go. Yep, okay then. Yeah, well, I'll be easy, thank you very much. I don't know how hard this bloody game is. Right, here we go. Iconic little something music there. Oh yeah, bugger. That's it. Oh, come on, I can't remember the controls again. So, controls are so hard to get used to every time you use an emulator on a different machine and you lose track of what, you know, I think I'm playing the GPD or something. And of course, I'm not. I'm playing the Ouya. Yeah, this has never been the easiest of games, guys, with the old wall crawling and so on, yeah. Ah yeah, bugger. Clear off, clear off. That's it. That's better. Go on you, up you go. Then you're gonna find another one, aren't you? Oh yes, swine. Ugh, bugger. Yeah, it's not doing too well here, guys. Completely confusing me again. That's it, that's better, come on. Oh bugger. As you can see, guys, little Samson NES games are playing beautifully on here. So there's PC Engine NES games, wow, you know, it's fantastic. Game Boy Advance games, brilliant, play brilliant on here. Right, back again in a minute. Right guys, shall we take a look at another full game? Let's have a look at Dead End, shall we? That seems to be quite a nicely rated game there. Yeah, let's have a look at that one. Right, let's see what this is like then. I can't remember, guys. Mission Garage. Oh, right, okay. Is that something to do with cars then? Could well be, couldn't it? It appears we have the demo of this one because it says unlock full game, but of course you might not be able to do that these days. But let's have a go anyway. Right, so Mission Garage, yeah, mission you. Okay, drift on a zombie, use a tip, do a max combo, blah 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 blah. Right, okay then, let's see how we go. Right, okay then. Yeah, oh, you're just gonna keep doing that to me. Okay, right. Right, so how do we play then? That's what I want to know. Oh, there we go. Oh, of course. Right, okay, we're not going to... Well, you can pause that if you want to have a look at that, guys. We're just going to go for it, see what the hell happens. Ah, right, okay, I get it. Yeah, blood on my windscreen now. Ah, so this is an interesting look to a game, isn't it? It's a bit different, isn't it? We're supposed to be hitting them a lot. Yeah. That is a very strange looking game, isn't it? Do remember it vaguely, Josh playing it, I do believe. I don't think you're supposed to hit them, and I don't think you're supposed to hit them either. They just burst my tyres, didn't they? Retry. Shall we have another go? Well, no. Let's have another go. Let's see if we can avoid them this time. Oh dear. So we avoid those things that burst your bloody tyres, that's for sure. There you go. Oh dear. Yeah, they get you and then you can't see. It's a bit like Mario Kart when they shoot that bloody oily crap at you, isn't it? Oh, yeah. I'm surviving the bursting the tyre bit at the moment. Really don't... You know, you would have thought it would be a slaughter fest and you're supposed to hit the zombies, but I don't think you are. Because obviously they make it, very hard to see then. Oh, okay. I doubt I'm going to die in a minute now. I'm going to get him anyway. Oh, what am I doing with him? Oh, no. Well, that was an interesting little thing, wasn't it, eh? Right, next one, guys. Right guys, we're going to have a look at some of the bits that have been sideloaded onto here. For this you have to go into make. So let's go in there. You go to builds, I do believe, is it? No, software. Here we go guys. So you can see there we've got lots of things on here. You've got a Aptoid browser for the internet. You've got the it was one of the best ever bloody file explorers, and of course it got taken off the Play Store, unfortunately. There we have some more emulators like N64 and so on. Shall we see if one of those will work? Yeah, let's have a look at what shall we have a look at? N64. Yeah, go on then. Have a look at the N64. See if it actually works at all. Oh, look at that. Wow. We'll go to the obvious one, shall we? Yeah, let's see if he's down here somewhere. There we are. Mario 64. Here we go. Let's have a look at that. See how that runs.
It's me, Mario. Hello.
Right, what is start? Oh, yes, of course. One of these, isn't it? I do believe. Yeah, that's it. Oh, 21 stars already? Oh, cheeky. I'll go over here. There we go. We'll start from the beginning. As you can hear, it sounds perfect. Let's see if we get any graphical glitches, guys. We all know the GPD plays these bloody N64 games like a dream, doesn't it? Absolutely fabulous. Let's see how the Ouya handles them. Well, hey, here he comes. A little plumber. Yeah, okay then, thank you. Right, let's go. Wow, the controls are lovely. Wow. Yeah, that is brilliant. Can we jump and slam though? Oh, how do we do that then? Ah, there we go. Right, so yeah, that's it. Brilliant, yeah. Okay, I know where I'm at then. Let's turn you around, you little bugger. Come on, what have we got? Let's go and get ourselves a star. After he stopped talking to you. Don't you always skip over for this? Of course you do. Well, it's certainly handling lovely. Right, let's go straight in here. So we can get ourselves a star. Right, up we go. Let's go with a little bit of a run around. Okay, thank you, bye. Might be a little bit of a lag there guys, tiny little bit of a lag, does not make it unplayable by any means, but there is a little lag. It's not as perfect as it would be on the GPT XD, especially on the Plus. Yeah, slight bit of lag, bit of frame skip in there as well, possibly. But yeah, as I say, it's still, still never get hit by those bloody things. It's still very, very playable though. Wow. Just going to go up and get the big bomb and then we'll be done with this one. Of course, Mario 64 is notoriously the easiest one to emulate. Everybody knows that Mario 64 works on most of the N64 emulators, even if other games really won't have it. So to have this little bit of a lag is not really very good. But what are you going to do? At least it's breathed some life into your Ouya, hasn't it? And it is still very playable. Here we go. Right, here we go. Hey, come on, you lot. Bloody bomb. Get over here. Let's see how you grab him now. I can't remember the controls there. Oh, it's not that one, that's for sure. I just slid under him. Oh dear. That one. Oh, there we go. Chuck him. Bye. Come on over here a bit. Then you start throwing things at them. Hey. Bye bye. And again, come on, one more. Well, this is playing fantastically considering that little bit of lag earlier. Yeah. Bye you. Yeah, just give me a star. Hurry up. Okay. Right, here we go guys. Get the old starling, yeah. Well, hey, there we go. Right guys, back in a minute. Right, last one in this section guys, where we've sideloaded it onto the Ouya. We're going to have a look at Genesis. There's only one game on here, Sonic the Hedgehog. Let's see how that plays, if it's full speed and all that. Oh, listen to that sound, guys. This certainly isn't at games, is it? No, that's a bloody show. Right, here we go, guys. Let's have a play. Just a quick level again. Oh, beautiful handling. Yeah, oh, wow. That is fantastic. Yeah, that has to be said. That is... Oh, you little swine. I'm right behind you. Can't talk and play at the same time, that's what the lore is there, I think. Yep, let's just scroll through this as much as we can. I'm going to worry about all the rings, of course. Yeah, get you little swine, and you, come on. Alright, there we go. Oh, this handle's like a bloody drain. Especially with this control pad, wow. Don't know why it gets so much stick, I really do not know. I think it's a brilliant, brilliant controller. I certainly haven't had any problems with it this time round. I have had sticky buttons in the past a little bit, but I certainly haven't this time. That's for bloody sure. Oh, we're not going to get around there, are we, stinker? Right, okay, here we go. Just trying to get through this level, guys. As you can see, it's running beautifully. What more can you possibly bloody want, eh? Nothing, that's what. There we go, guys. Fantastic, yeah. Okay, guys, right. Well, that's that one. Back in a sec. This is actually something I've got to show you guys. When you get to certain parts in these emulators and things, and you think, oh my God, I can't press a button to close it or anything like that. You do actually, in the middle of the Ouya control pad, as you can see there, in the middle is that black pad there, which is blank, has nothing on it. Just here, guys, yeah, that is actually a mouse, as you can see here. That is a mouse, that is a touchpad. So you can just go on to close, for instance, here, and come out of it by double tapping it. He says, oh no, it's not having it. Ooh, naughty thing. Let's see if I have to go a bit further down or something. Of course, being an emulator, that's the way they sometimes work, isn't it? Yes. Okay, right. Let's try again. There we go. Go down to it that way, can we? No. Okay then, right. But yeah, that is a little mouse pad there, even though it completely let me down on that particular one. Let's try again, guys. Right, let's see. Get out of it. There we go. Let's see if it's going to do it this time with a different one here, maybe. No, you're still not going to have it now. No, still not having it, guys. But yeah, anyway, to get around the menus of a lot of these emulators, you use this little bugger here, even though he's completely and utterly putting me to shame right now by not working. Rat. Okay then, guys. Back again in a minute. Right, for the last full game, Ouya game, shall we have a look at Car Jumper? That sounds interesting, doesn't it? Yeah, let's have a look. Right, here we go. Let's see what this does then. Oh, it's powered by Unity, so it can't be a terrible, terrible game, really. Let's see, shall we? Oh, it says press O to continue, but it's not. Oh, there we go. Right. Okay. Oh, this is very weird looking. Let's be Ross then, shall we? Right. Okay, I get it. Yeah. You have to literally jump over the... Oh, yes. Oh, look at all that blood. Jesus Christ. Oh, I love the way he's humming. That's funny. I have to say, it's very surreal, but kind of fun. Oh my God, they must have just had somebody in the recording studio just going... Oh, that's hilarious. Oh, I did awesome, apparently, 32. What happened there? Hopefully that goes away in a minute. Oh, this is... Oh, seriously, man. Oh, dear me. 32 again. Right, one more time, come on. I wonder how much this person got paid for doing that, eh? Oh, we knocked him off his bike. Oh, police car. Oh, we've got to jump over him a bit more. Jeez Louise. Oh, there we go, another one. Another one. Car coming, yeah, of course there is. I think I've beaten my own record anyway. That is just the surrealest soundtrack to a game ever. Oh, there we go. Oh, wow, 309 guys, wow. Right, well, that was actually surprisingly fun, even though it's crap at the same time, but it was surprisingly fun, especially putting up with that. Well, I would have to turn it down after a while if I was playing that longer. How annoying is that? It's like having... oh, dear, well, it's like having a load of kids running around the house. That was annoying. Oh, dear me. Yeah. Oh well guys, see you again in a sec and I'll give you my... Oh no, we're going to take a look at one more thing guys. We're going to take a look at one more emulator and then we're going to be done with my final thoughts. Right, ready? Right, shall we have a look at how SNES games play on here? Yay, let's do that. Who doesn't love bloody SNES? I do. Oh, gone into the wrong bit again. Here we go again. Deary me. Right, here we go guys. Oh, the buttons, they do throw you a bit sometimes. Right, let's have a look what we've got here. Ooh. We've got a nice little selection there, haven't we? Yeah, what shall we go for? He says, oh, let's go for the usual. Yeah, come on. Come on, Nintendo, smack me other arse cheek now as well. Yeah, sounds very good. Can't find a fault in that at all. Right, let's go for it then, shall we? Come on you. Which one are we now? Which one guys, come on. It'll be one of them. Oh, there we go. It was the shoulder button, guys. So, am I allowed? Oh, see that graphical glitch at the top there? Oh, that's not too hot, is it, eh? Well, let's see how we get on anyway. Oh, we're speeding up at the moment. I'm not even using it. Right, okay, yeah, no, that seems to be a bit of a buggy mess, guys, doesn't it? That's a shame, isn't it? Maybe in the settings we can do something. So, yeah, a bit of a fail there, guys, unfortunately, on the SNES games. I couldn't quite remember if I had tried using them before or not. Oh, we've gone into it now. Let's see if it performs better if once we're actually in a bloody game. Let's see. Let's start with... Yeah, we'll do that one. So it's on the analog stick, the right one. You just click it down to actually start the game. Oh, look at that. It's getting worse, guys, isn't it? So it's not looking very hot for SNES games on here. Let's see how we get on anyway. When the actual playing of the thing. No, oh dear me, look at that. Yeah, look at that, that's not good, guys. I don't think we can go any further really, can we? Let's see what happens, but I don't think so. Let's see. Oh, it's cleared up now. Shall we see then? Yeah, let's see. Oh, that's looking all right. Yeah, that's not looking too bad at all, is it? So, once you get into it, into the actual gameplay, it's improved a hell of a lot, hasn't it? So maybe there's some saving grace there after all. Oh, here we go again. Yeah, here we go again. It's going to happen every now and then by the looks of it, guys. But yeah, I mean, it's still playable, isn't it? By a bit of a stretch, really. But it is, it's still playable. Let's see if it does it again. Oh, I mean, come on, it's still playable, yeah, absolutely. I mean, even if it does it every now and then, you know, it's not, oh, here we go again, see. But yeah, it doesn't make it unplayable. There we go, yeah. Where are you, the horrible things that are golfers or whatever the hell they are meant to be. Yeah, I'm just going to keep going here. Oh, you got me. Right, well, guys, that was, SNES emulation for you. Right. Back in a sec with my final thoughts, guys. So there you go, guys. That's the Ouya for you. But the question still remains, doesn't it? Should you invest into one in 2020, guys? Well, in my opinion, absolutely. Absolutely. They go for as little as £29, guys. I've even seen one go for £25. I think CX charged something like £29 for one. A little bit more if it's boxed and what have you, but absolutely, why wouldn't you? You can sideload emulators onto it. You can sideload the games onto it. Yeah, you can't get onto the internet anymore with it. Well, into the store anyway. You don't seem to be able to anyway. Razer must have quit that and shut it down completely now. For a long time you could still get there and get the Ouya software, but unfortunately not anymore, it would seem. But yeah, and of course if you're a collector, it's one of those. See, I'm a lover of the underdog, guys. I love the underdog, and the Ouya performed so badly I want it in my collection just for that sheer fact. There's not going to be a lot of them around in the future either, guys. So yeah, and that reminds me of some of my all-time favourite handheld, yeah. He was like that as well, wasn't he? Yeah, the underdog that did so poorly. So yeah, and we know how he's come up in value, don't we? This little bugger will set you back a fair bit, guys, to get your hands on one of these little sods. Oh, I love you. I really do. But I love you as well. I do like the underdogs, I did say. Mwah. Yeah. So yes, guys, in my opinion, grab one. Grab one while they're cheap, because I have a feeling that they're going to go up in value, because people know that they can load all this stuff onto it. So once they've loaded it all onto there, it's there permanently and it's in their collection. And just for the aesthetics of it alone, I mean, this gorgeous looking little thing sitting on your shelf with the control pads like I have it displayed, you know, it looks lovely. It's niche, isn't it? It's a niche thing. And it's a footnote in gaming history, guys. A bad one. It did poorly, but it's a footnote. And, you know, like a lot of the consoles I have in my collection, handhelds particularly, like the Supervision, it was a failure. The Nokia N-Gage, it was a failure. But I love to have them in my collection. So if you're anything like me and you want to get your hands on them, the Atari Jaguar was a failure. So yeah, do you love the underdog? Then bloody go out and grab this one as well. Because you can get them cheap now. Grab them while they're cheap. That's always my motto, guys. The same with game collecting. You know, SNES might be valuable that minute. NES might be valuable that minute.
go for the others. Don't bother with them. Don't bother with the ones that are charging these high prices. Go for the ones that are cheap. PS2, dirt cheap at the moment. Grab those while you can. Always grab the underdog, guys, the ones that aren't charging so much. I say the underdog, the PS2 was absolutely stonking, which is why the games are so cheap. But yeah, always go with the cheaper ones first, and then, you know, you'll find what will happen is, say for instance, SNES is high up there, 1 minute, it'll be down again the next, when the N64 is suddenly more collectible, because people live on nostalgia. Now, the people that are coming up now from university and so on, they weren't playing on the bloody NES. They weren't playing on the SNES, they were playing on the N64, and they've got money to burn in their pockets, so those are going up in value. So yeah, that is a theory I live by, guys. Buy the cheaper ones and wait. Just be patient. Collecting and building up a game room is all about patience. Patience is a virtue, guys, and that is really, really true. You will come across these things in the end, and at the right price that you feel comfortable paying. So yeah, guys, grab yourself an Ouya. Yeah, go on, get it now while you can, before they're all bloody gone. Because they will come to a point where you won't be able to get hold of them anymore. And it's the same with the game stick and things like that. You know, if you can get hold of one, do it. All the microcomputers, grab them, because they all failed, didn't they? What microcomputer didn't fail, for God's sake, out of this lot, you know? Yeah, that's my opinion, guys. So that's my final thoughts on the matter. Yeah, to me, it's still a little winner. Yeah, it's got a few problems with the SNES games there, didn't it? But it might only have been Mario, of course, but we couldn't make a video any bloody longer. We would have been here on bloody day and night, wouldn't we? So yeah, grab it while you can, guys. So, with all that said, guys, yeah, I would just like to remind you about that Nintendo Switch, mate. It's at Fort Amherst on the 9th of February. Don't forget. Sunday 9th of February. And yeah, bring your kids, bring your Switches. We're all going to have a big fat Switch party, aren't we? Yeah, at Fort Amherst at the Pantry, the lovely, lovely little coffee shop stroke cafe. You can purchase some lovely locally sourced cakes, and all the sandwiches, toasties, paninis, baguettes, all that are all made with locally sourced ingredients. So yeah, if you want to come along and have a fantastic, fantastic day, I'll be there with my kids, and you get to meet me. And so if you're in the Chatham area, Medway, Kent, make your way over there on the 9th of February, guys, for a fantastic Nintendo Switch meet. And I'm going to stop rabbiting on now, and I'm going to say, auf Wiedersehen. Oh, no, I'm not. I'm not going to do that at all. I'm going to say to you, if you like what you see, please tap the bell icon to be notified of any up and coming videos I do. And please like, comment and subscribe. Now I'm going to go. I'll see you later, guys. Auf Wiedersehen. Goodbye and cheers. And I'll see you in the next one, guys. Bye-bye.